handa ng pagmamahal ng Diyos na nakikita sa pagkita ng pagmahal ng buong simbahan. I think that's our dream. That's our dream for every parish, for every diocese, so that I think we hope and we pray hard that the Spirit will guide us so that after 2 years, the Church of São Paulo will radiate itself, and even in the process, hearts will be transformed because all people will participate in this, then this will have to make the sacrifice of time. And that's the reason why we go slowly, because the Spirit works in a slow way. The Spirit works in a slow way. All these, a change of structure without education, without that, the structure will recreate itself. Because the most important is our way of looking at reality, our Christian vision. And the one that will strengthen us in time of conflict will always be Christian vision. In our institute, when people are at odds with each other, the one that can manage the conflict is to look in the same direction and to appeal to that vision. What is our vision? Because we are human beings, we will always be in tension. We'll always have different viewpoints. But every time again, when there are arguments, I think we will have to remain quiet and listen to the God in us, amidst us, and above us, and around us. Okay, so that is the three components of this site. So in Asian Social Institute, Mojo for Why is we have a course, it's called Philosophy of Commitment to Total Human Development, that is PCPHD, and within that, we teach Christian social teachings. But the first exercise in this course is how to breathe. Because the way you breathe is the way to your life, your health, and being. Is it not? You can meditate through the breath. Christian meditation is through the breath. The one who teaches us that is Dr. Susan Gray. How to do Christian meditation with the way of the breath. And therefore, it is also very transformative. The way to breathe. We have exercises, oriented exercises, that has the philosophy that if you breathe only from here, then the whole society, the rest of your body will be sick because your energy is not distributed. We will have arthritis, we will have all kinds of things. That's why every day I still do exercises. And therefore, that exercises, which has a philosophy behind it, it's not just physical exercise, there's a philosophy behind it. After that, we have a theory of part more philosophy. After that, what are the three elements that give meaning in life and that give happiness to life? Of Viktor Frankl. And then we will have, instead of an exam, we will have a feast where people bring in cultural food from all. And when we bring culture food for all, we ask the whole community of ASEAN, including our security guards, to gate crash and partake of the food. And then at the very end, then we have Christian social teachings, immersion in the communities, creation spirituality. The end of that is an agape. More liturgical, more being Christian. The first feast is being human. The second feast is being Christian, agape. And that is very, and then the people make a credo of what do I believe. The modules for what is we teach them how to analyze the culture, how to analyze society, economic analysis, social work theories, research, quantitative, and phenomenology. The why modules of the how to bridge the gap. Then we teach them community building, pastoral communication, pastoral planning and management, human relations training, conflict management, disaster risk reduction and management, and community economics. Others talk about, for instance, what happens to the rice that is harvested? Follow the rice where it's growing. And they narrate, where do they sell it? Where does it go? You know, and so on. That's community economics. And find out how the communities will not sell their food outside unless the community themselves have sufficient and adequate food. So that there will be food sovereignty and not like now when all the rejects will be for Filipinos, the rest will be exported. The bananas will be only have the señoritas, the rest are outside. Sometimes the heads, the body of the fish are in the sardines. We Filipinos eat only the heads. Ulo Ulo restaurant. There is one restaurant in Commonwealth, only ulo. And then you have the chicken, undressed, no more feathers. The people eat only the heads and the feet. The Adidas and the helmet. Yan, ang mga Pilipino kasi, magandang sense of humor natin eh. Pag mahirap tayo, bigyan natin ang mga magandang names yung ating paghihirap para hindi tayo feeling nahirap. That's why I think that's a very good trait of the Filipinos. We are people who have hope because God is a God of hope, because we are believers. They say that the Filipinos are the first religious country in the world, which means they are believers. Not necessarily that they believe what they believe, that they believe. Second, they are one of the happiest people in the world. The third is they are the most romantic. And that's why in Valentine's Day, even here, you receive a heart balloon from the bishop. All the rest had it, you know. We are a people like that. So this is the framework that we use for guiding. And now, this is two-year evangelizing process. So here, every activity is an evangelizing activity, even the research. The research is part of listening to people with compassion. Listening to people with compassion so that we will know and they will also be aware of their own realities. I think that's all. The rest will the whole two-year accompaniment. People who came were so excited